California's attorney general is calling for sweeping police reform after a black man's hanging death. Robert Fuller was 24 years old. His body was discovered hanging from a tree in Palmdale City last week. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department ruled it a suicide, but his family says he was lynched. Protesters took to the streets over the weekend calling for a full investigation. Jonathan Vigliotti reports.
Justice!
What do we want?
Now!
Hundreds gathered near Palmdale City Hall over the weekend demanding answers about the hanging death of Robert Fuller. His body was discovered by a passerby around 3:40 Wednesday morning.
We sitting here staring at this tree. It don't make no sense.
That's right.
Fuller's sister, Diamond Alexander, spoke next to the tree where her brother was found.
We've been hearing one thing, then we hear another.
Right.
And we just want to know the truth.
Can I also ask that we stop talking about lynchings?
No.
At issue, a series of press releases claiming suicide before a full investigation was complete and linking Fuller's death to COVID-19 related depression.
It appears that Mr. Fuller has tragically died by suicide. A full autopsy.
The city of Palmdale is calling for an investigation by the state attorney general. Family members like Fuller's cousin, Pernisha Theus, said he wasn't depressed.
He was not suicidal. He had no mental illnesses, and we don't want that to be implied.
Protesters are now calling for justice for Robert Fuller.
Why would you put out a public statement saying that it was possible suicide if you don't have all the answers?
For a black man to be hung in a tree near City Hall, that's a message.
2 weeks ago, another black man, 38-year-old Malcolm Harsh, was found hanging from a tree in neighboring San Bernardino County. Officials say they found no sign of foul play. While detectives are still investigating the case, Harsh's family issued a statement to a local paper expressing concern that his death will be waved off as a suicide to avoid any further media attention. Meanwhile, celebrities, including Kim Kardashian West and Viola Davis, are taking to social media, adding their voices to those seeking answers in Robert Fuller's death.
We're not letting up. We're not letting this get swept under the rug.
Jonathan Vigliotti, CBS News, Palmdale, California.
For more, CBS News campaign reporter Musadiq Bidar joins me now. Hi, Musadiq. California's Attorney General Xavier Becerra is calling for police reform. What are his recommendations to law enforcement?
Elaine, the proposals are largely aimed at reducing the use of excessive force and increasing accountability and transparency for police. As part of that, Attorney General Xavier Becerra is calling for a ban on chokeholds and any kind of restraints that restrict blood and oxygen flow to the brain. This is exactly, of course, how George Floyd was murdered in Minneapolis. Becerra is also calling for police officers to monitor each other and call out when their partners or other officers are using excessive force. He is also calling for restrictions on law enforcement to use tear gas and rubber bullets and protests, which, of course, is timely given the protests across the country.
Well, you report that some of his recommendations will need to go through the state legislature, including the guidance around decertifying police officers. What more do we know about that?
That's right. That is a new idea that the attorney general floated out today. He said he has been in touch with several lawmakers about this. Of course, you would need legislation from the state lawmakers to make this happen and be able to enforce it. Becerra said it's an idea that's going to get a lot of attention. Of course, he wasn't sure what the legislation would look like, how you'd decertify police officers, and what exactly is meant by use of excessive force. So these are questions that still need to be answered, and the Attorney General acknowledged that these will be part of ongoing conversations in the next few weeks.
Well, Becerra's announcement comes amid nationwide protests against police brutality and racism in the wake of George Floyd's death. How did he address that Monday, and did he address the growing calls for his office to investigate the death of Robert Fuller?
Well, he acknowledged that there is systematic racism that allows for police brutality. And he did say that his office will be investigating the death of Robert Fuller. He said DOJ investigators will be on the scene. The FBI is also going to be assisting with this matter. And Becerra said that we do deserve protection in our neighborhoods in response to calls for police to be defunded. This is something that a lot of demonstrators have been calling. But Becerra said he's not exactly sure what that means. How do you defund the police? He said if that means reforming police officers and law enforcement, then he is all for it. But at the same time, there are several police departments around California that are moving in that direction. The Los Angeles City Council is going to take a look at their budget for the police department. And of course, San Francisco just this past weekend also said that their police officers will respond to situations involving neighbor disputes, for example, with non-lethal officers who are not equipped with lethal weapons. So the Attorney General did say that he's going to look at the investigation in Palmdale, and they'll be involved with it throughout.
All right, Musadiq Bidar for us. Good to see you again, Moose. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Elaine.